Hey, it's Film It Fridays again with Connor from Brisbane FTV. Today I'm just going to take you through our setup, which is focusing on reflections and how to use them creatively. So at the moment, I'll take you through the lighting of the main scene. This is a practical lamp that we've used, to have a light in the scene. Creates a fair bit of mood. It's actually filling our subject quite nicely. For our environment lighting, we've used a 300 watt with a red gel shining through a cookie cutter just to give a bit of texture on the back wall. It's just not a red flood, so it's actually a little bit dynamic and interesting. And what we have for our edge light and our hair light is a Dido, just on spot, just to create a bit of edge and separate our subject from the background, make it interesting and dynamic. So now we're on the other side of the glass. What we've done is we set up our camera so that it was offset from the glass, and what we've done is we've used a polarizer filter. Now, the point of this polarizer is so that we can reduce the reflections that appear in the glass, and we also used it so that it crispened up Chaster's reflection. Because I lit him well, you can't reduce that completely with the polarizer, but what it did do is sort of crisp him up and reduce those other nasty reflections that we didn't want. And the way that we lit Chaster is we just had a simple LED that we would turn on and shine above scene. That would light our subject, and then when we Azel would turn around, we simply would just turn it off and he would disappear, and it creates that sort of horror trope. How we also made Chaster's reflection pop is that this left-hand side was a lot darker, so when we lit him, you know, he was lit and the reflection was appearing on a darker background. So if you utilize your contrast, you'll get that clear separation from the highlight of the reflection and the darkness of the background. So yeah, I hope you guys utilize some reflections in your films, and best of luck.